When it comes to picturing an agent of NBA players, most people will be thinking about a Woody Allen type. But that's not necessarily the case. There are some agents out there who could drop 30 on you with ease. One of them is Mitchell Butler, a person who spent 8 years in the NBA and now is using his experience to help his clients.
What's the toughest part of your job?
The toughest part of the job? There are a lot of tough aspects about the job. I enjoy it because I played the game, I know what I wanted from my agent, and I just try to provide those same things for my clients.
Well, who are some of your clients?
I have Earl Watson, I have Jarvis Hayes, I have Juan Dixon, and then we represent a whole host of other players.
How did you become an agent though?
I've worked 1 year as a player development coach in the league, and that was fun. I wanted to do something that was a little bit more stable for my family, keep me at home a little bit more. I have two daughters that are, getting into high school. So, it's that time, in your life where you gotta, think more about your family and less about yourself.
What do you say about the NBA this year? Any favorites? Who do you think?
This year, I think it's going to be the Lakers are obviously one of the top teams. Boston's they're the reigning champs, so you got to knock them off before anything else. Before you can talk about anybody else. You've got Cleveland that's playing well. The Spurs, the Rockets, I think are talented and very, very deep. Orlando's talented and pretty deep as well. It's going to be fun to watch. I'll tell you that much. It'll be a barn burner towards the end there when you get to the semifinals and the finals of each conference and then to the NBA finals.
It seems like the guys from your generation had much better skills an idea of the game than the new guys who are crazy athletic, but they don't have so much understanding.
Well, I think we come from an era of basketball where, we learn from the Magic Johnsons, the Larry Birds, the Isaiah Thomas, Mark Aguirre's, and those guys learn from guys who were specialists. They learn from the Marcus Johnsons, the David Thompsons, George Gervins, guys that were really good at doing a lot of things out on the floor. And I think you probably hit an era of basketball where people are so into the ESPN highlights and making the highlight reel that it's more about the individual and less about the team. But overall, though, I would say basketball is in good hands. Some of these young players are really, really talented and it's fun to watch it.
Would you give a young person who wants to be like yourself and become an agent? Where should they start?
I would just say, basically it would start with building relationships while they're young. Remember all the people they come into contact with in high school. Obviously try to develop good relationships while you're in college. And because my business is truly about relationships. And if you've got good, solid relationships, that can carry you a long way.
So if you want to become an agent of athletes, get an internship with the current agent and learn the business from within. In Los Angeles, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.